iPhone 13 versus iPhone 13 Pro. Which should you choose? An iPhone 13 versus an iPhone 13 Pro comparison is just what you need if you're thinking of buying one of Apple's new handsets, both of which are available right now, but aren't sure which is right for you. As expected, the iPhone 13 comes in four models, and if that strategy sounds familiar, that's because Apple also launched four iPhone 12 models nearly a year ago. But this time, the gap between the regular and Pro series is even bigger. Sure, the iPhone 13 mini, iPhone 13, iPhone 13 Pro, and iPhone 13 Pro Max also have plenty in common, from the all-new A15 Bionic chip to a faster 5G and a smaller notch. Most of that is down to the new 120Hz ProMotion display and the improved cameras. But there are other differences around battery life, colors, and, of course, price. This iPhone 13 versus iPhone 13 Pro comparison should give you a good idea of which one is right for you. iPhone 13 versus iPhone 13 Pro, prices and storage. Available to buy right now, the iPhone 13 mini starts at $699. The iPhone 13 at $799, and the iPhone 13 Pro at $999. And the iPhone 13 Pro Max at $1,099. Storage-wise, the 64GB option has been dropped, with all four phones starting at 128GB, then having 256GB and 512GB versions. But the iPhone 13 Pro and iPhone 13 Pro Max get one advantage here, in the form of a massive 1TB model. As always, the iPhone 13 mini and iPhone 13 have a big price advantage, but if lots of storage is important to you, you'll want to look at the Pro models. iPhone 13 versus iPhone 13 Pro, design and colors. The good news here is that all four new iPhone 13 models get smaller notches. They've been reduced by 20%, which means you'll get a little more screen real estate, whichever one you're using. That aside, the design of the iPhone 13 range isn't massively different from that of the iPhone 12 models. Size-wise, they're all near identical to last year's models. Other than being a tiny bit thicker, 0.30 inches rather than 0.29, the color options for the two phones are also wildly different. The iPhone 13 mini and iPhone 13 get five hues: Starlight, Midnight, Blue, Pink, and Product Red. Meanwhile, the iPhone 13 Pro and Pro Max only get four choices, but to our eyes, at least they're more subtle and attractive. Here you can pick from graphite, gold, silver, and Sierra Blue. Finally, the iPhone 13 Pro and iPhone 13 Pro Max have a textured matte glass rear, whereas the iPhone 13 and 13 mini have a standard glass finish. Ultimately, there's not much in it when it comes to design, and it's unlikely that it'll sway your decision as to which model to buy. iPhone 13 versus iPhone 13 Pro displays. All four iPhone 13 models keep the same screen size as previously, with the iPhone 13 mini sporting a 5.4-inch display, and the standard iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 Pro has a 6.1-inch screen. The iPhone 13 Pro Max is the biggest, of course, and has a 6.7-inch display. All four models make use of Apple's new Super Retina XDR OLED displays. On the iPhone 12, the display has a typical outdoor brightness of 800 nits and a peak level of 1200 in HDR mode, making for a hike of 28% in brightness. Comparatively, the displays on the iPhone 13 Pro Max models are 1000 nits in typical outdoor use and can also hit a peak of 1200. But the biggest difference between the iPhone 13 and the iPhone 13 Pro handsets is that the later models have a ProMotion display that sports an adaptive refresh rate, allowing the display to go from a speedy 120Hz to 10Hz to conserve battery life. iPhone 13 versus iPhone 13 Pro cameras. All four iPhone 13 models deliver impressive phone photography, and the iPhone 13, 13 Pro, and 13 Pro Max have all earned a place on the best camera phones list. But there are notable differences between the pair of rear cameras on the iPhone 13 and the trio of snappers on the iPhone 13 Pro models. The iPhone 13 has a new sensor in its 12-megapixel main camera, which lets in 47% more light for improved nighttime photography, while the 12-megapixel ultra-wide camera gets a faster sensor. These cameras are configured in a diagonal line rather than a vertical one, as seen on the iPhone 12. and they deliver impressive results with bright and colorful shots and improved nighttime photography on the ultra-wide camera, as well as 4 times more scene capture. The ultra-wide camera now offers what Apple claims is a 92% improvement in low-light photography, and it also has support for a macro mode, allowing users to get close-ups of very small objects. It's with the macro mode where the iPhone 13 Pro phones beat their standard siblings, offering better extreme close-ups. Meanwhile, the telephoto camera on the iPhone 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max, something the iPhone 13 lacks, has received a solid upgrade. The new 77mm telephoto lens now has a 6x optical zoom range, with a digital zoom of up to 15x. This new telephoto camera not only beats the iPhone 13 by its mere inclusion, but also offers more zooming capabilities than the iPhone 12 Pro. With a wider f1.5 aperture, it lets in more light too. Much like last year, the iPhone 13 Pro models have the edge over the standard iPhones regarding camera specs. The question is whether you want to fork out a good bit more money for the extra lens and some advanced features. iPhone 13 vs. iPhone 13 Pro Video. All 4 iPhone 13 handsets can capture video at up to 4K and 60 frames per second, and all phones put in solid point-and-shoot video performance. As has been the case with the past few generations of iPhone, aside from the extra telephoto camera, the iPhone 12 Pro has the advantage in a video by being able to capture using ProRes, Apple's new high-quality, lossy video compression format aimed at people who want more control over editing their videos yet don't want to swamp phone storage with uncompressed videos. However, if you only have the 128GB iPhone 12 Pro, ProRes is limited to shooting 1080p videos at 30 frames per second rather than the 4K at the same frame rate. iPhone 13 vs. iPhone 13 Pro Performance. All iPhone 13 models come with the new Apple A15 Bionic chip. Built on a 5-nanometer process, the chip comes with 6 processor cores, 2 for demanding tasks and 4 for less rigorous workloads to increase efficiency. Overall, Apple claims the A15 Bionic offers 50% faster performance than the leading competition. Here's looking at you, Qualcomm. But it's on the graphics side. We see some disparity between the iPhone 13 and the iPhone 13 Pro. The former has 4 GPU cores, while the latter has 5. Apple claims the iPhone 13 offers 30% better graphics performance than leading Android phones, but noted that the extra core in the A15 Bionic for the iPhone 12 Pro handset would offer 50% more graphics performance than rival chips. iPhone 13 hit 55.9 FPS in the 3D Mark Wildlife benchmark in graphics testing, while the iPhone 13 Pro managed a very impressive 70 FPS. That extra GPU core is working hard, so if you want the best gaming performance, then you'll want to go for the iPhone 13 Pro. Not that the standard phone will let you down either. iPhone 13 vs. iPhone 13 Pro Battery. All iPhone 13 models come with the new Apple A15 Bionic chip. Built on a 5-nanometer process, the chip comes with 6 processor cores, 2 for demanding tasks and 4 for less rigorous workloads to increase efficiency. Overall, Apple claims the A15 Bionic offers 50% faster performance than the leading competition. So if you want the best battery life, then the iPhone 13 Pro models are the phones to go for. But the iPhone 13 still beats the iPhone 12 for electrical endurance. iPhone 13 vs. iPhone 13 Pro Verdict. Overall, all 4 iPhone 13 models are relatively iterative upgrades over their predecessors, but they are, nevertheless, the best iPhones you can buy today. If you want the very best in phone photography, performance, and display from Apple, then you'll want the iPhone 13 Pro or 13 Pro Max. Be prepared to pay a hefty price for the latter. The ProMotion display might be the biggest difference to consider, as once you go 120Hz, it's difficult to go back.